Welcome to all on this auspicious day of the appearance of Srimati Radharani Sri Radhashtami to talk and hear about the Supreme Mother. Even though we are not qualified so much to speak and hear and discuss, she is very merciful and give us an opportunity to talk about her and serve her. Shri Guru Bhyo Namaha. Shri Guru Gauranga Jayate. Bhajami Radha Aravinda Netram. Smarami Radha Madhura Smitasyam. Vadami Radha Karuna Bharadram. Tato mamainasti gatir navapi. So Radharani, as you know, appeared before Krishna in a place called Raval, and a father, Vrishabhanu, he found her and took her home. He found this very beautiful child, took her home, and considered her his own daughter, and brought her up. She was very beautiful child, but she wouldn't open her eyes until when there was a time when Krishna was born, and after his birth, he came to meet Radha, Yashoda, Nanda. Everybody went to Vrishabhanu's palace. And the moment little Krishna peeped and looked at Radharani, Sri Radha opened her eyes because she wanted to see Krishna as the first object. So that is a position Radharani has, and Radharani gave to Krishna. She knows nobody other than Krishna, and Krishna knows nobody other than Sri Radha. However, even though she has such an exalted position, she has not been mentioned anywhere in the Vedas, even in Srimad Bhagavatam. As we know, Sukadev Goswami only explained one particular gopi whom Krishna carried away in the midst of Rasa Leela, or one gopi who left the Rasa Leela, and Krishna stopped the Rasa Leela. So Sri Radha, he only uses the word one very fortunate and one who worships the Lord perfectly. So that is Radha, who is expert in Aradhana. She is Radha. She expertly makes Krishna happy with her services, captures his attention, gives pleasure to Krishna with her activities and seva, and that is why she is called Radhika. So this personality is the most important person for, especially for Gaudiya Vaishnavas and all the Krishna Bhaktas who cherish the Vrindavan atmosphere of bhakti. So Vedas don't talk, Bhagavatam doesn't talk, specifically Srutis don't talk. Of course, she has been mentioned in Gautamiya Tantra, certain Samhitas. So she brings in so much joy to Krishna. She is the most important personality in the Krishna Leela, life of Krishna in Vrindavan. As it is said, Krishna never leaves Vrindavan. He is always Vrindavan. Radharani never leaves Vrindavan. So Krishna automatically stays there. So Vrindavan Krishna, Krishna and Radha, that is the subject of meditation for Vaishnavas. Vyasadeva, when he spoke, he wanted to speak, bring out Bhagavatam. He chose Sukadeva Goswami as a speaker. Because there was no greater monist than Sukadeva Goswami, greater impersonalist than Sukadeva Goswami. As we have heard, he walked out after his birth and didn't want to get attracted to the material Maya and always want to be in Brahmananda. He was always experiencing the pleasure of monism, Brahmananda, our spirit, greatest transcendentalist. So he wanted this greatest transcendentalist to talk about the transcendental activities of the Supreme Lord to capture the minds of the people. And the acceptance Srimad Bhagavatam would get, which talks about Krishna Leela, would be automatic. Everybody would accept that. So that's how Vyasadeva sent word for Sukadeva Goswami. You may be a transcendentalist. Nivritta Tasrai Upagiyamana. Giving up everything and enjoying this Brahmarasa. But you have an Aushadi. Bhavaushadi. Manobhiramaha. Which can enchant your mind. So that is how Sukadeva Goswami learned Bhagavatam, the activities of the Supreme Lord, and the great monist became a great devotee, spoke about Radha and Krishna, spoke about Krishna basically, his leelas, to enchant the mind of all the people of Kali Yuga so that everybody gets an opportunity to know this personality, surrender to this personality, with whose help one can get Krishna. And he did not speak of her, give her name. So we understand the position of Radharani in the minds of great Vaishnavas, great devotees. So the same taste is maintained in the entire Gaudiya Sampradaya, respecting the position of Srimati Radharani, the Supreme Mother of all living entities, provider of bhakti, to the devotees who want Krishna, who engages the devotees in serving Krishna. So this is Sri Radha. So Sri Radha, she enchants the mind of Krishna. Krishna is called Kanta. Kanta means one who enchants everybody, everybody's mind. Materialist in one way, spiritualist in another way, devotees in another way. He enchants the mind of everybody. But Sri Radha is Kanti. She enchants the mind of the enchanter of others. So she is Kanti. That's her position. Hari, Supreme Lord, is called Hari. Who attracts attention, who takes away the attention towards him of all the people. And Sri Radha is Hara. Who enchants Hari. So she captures the mind of the Supreme Lord. And she was made for that. Krishna's own potency, Krishna's pleasure expansion, the first pleasure expansion for his own pleasure. So the Supreme Lord, he needs pleasure. Raso Vaisaha, Vedas say, is full of pleasure. Always increasing. Not decreasing pleasure, like in the material world. The spiritual pleasure increases. The Supreme Lord's existence is such that, in fact, the Jiva's existence, spirit soul's existence is such that they're always in pleasure, Satchit Ananda. In the spiritual realm, there's nothing but Vardhana of Rasa. And Krishna has expanded his pleasure potency expansion as Sri Radha. So why would the Supreme Lord want another person to give him pleasure? You may ask that question. अभिघ्नस्वराट जन्माद्यस्योन्वया इतरतश्चार्ते अभिघ्नस्वराट ही स्वराट सुप्रीमली इंडिपेंडेंट यू कैन से ऑटोक्रेटिकली इंडिपेंडेंट ही डज नॉट नीड एनीथिंग आउटसाइड हिम ऑफ हिम फॉर अ प्लेजर इन दिस वर्ल्ड वी ऑल नीड समथिंग आउटसाइड अवर बॉडी फॉर प्लेजर सेंस प्लेजर्स मेंटल प्लेजर्स इंटेलेक्चुअल इंक्विजिटिवनेस egoistic possession. So we need something from outside us. But Krishna does not need something outside him to give him pleasure. So what does he do? He creates this personality from his own self. So he is enjoying his pleasure potency. So finally, it's only one Supreme Lord. It's not two Supreme Lords. So Supreme Lord Krishna is the most predominating person. And Sri Radha is a predominated. Only one Purusha is Krishna. Everything else is Prakriti, which is predominated by the predominator. So Sri Radha is Krishna himself, his pleasure aspect for his own enjoyment. This is the position of Krishna. This is the position of Radha. He does not need anybody else. So people may wonder, what is the Supreme Lord? He is after somebody else. He is after himself. He is not after anybody else. So this two personalities, who is actually one person, that personality provides what the Purusha wants. In fact, all the jivas are expansions of the Supreme Lord. Ajivas are not the own expansion of Krishna like Radharani is. So Sri Radha is Krishna himself, his pleasure aspect, his enjoying aspect, his object of enjoyment which has come from himself. So he is Atmarama, is a perfect Atmarama who enjoys in himself. But in spiritual world, he has all these personalities coming out of him. The jivas are separated entities who have a choice to be with him or not. Sri Radharani is not like that. So as Krishnadas Kaviraj says in Chaitanya Charitamrita, Devi Krishnamai Prota Radhika Paradevata. Krishnamayi. Krishna himself. He is not different. Krishna himself. Radhika Paradevata. Devata, who is Devata? All the Devatas are there. But Krishna is the Ati Devata. He is the man. He is the Supreme Devata. But she is a Devata of that Supreme Devata. Paradevata. Radhika Paradevata. Sarva Lakshmi Mayi. Sarva Kanti Samoini Para. All the Lakshmis are her expansion. All the primary Sakis. So the same Krishna. So Krishna enjoys himself. He doesn't take enjoyment from anything other than himself. He doesn't need that. And that is the position of the Supreme Lord. The Gaudi understanding, the full understanding. No doubts of how the Lord is dependent on anything. He is not dependent on anything other than himself. So Swaraj. So that statement of the Vedas, the statement of Bhagavatam is maintained. He doesn't need anything else. He is not subservient. He is subservient to himself. He is subservient to his own pleasure potency. Sarvakanti. Sammohini, a word used by Krishnadas Kaviraj is Sammohini. Total bewilderment. Totally bewildering Krishna. So that is Krishna in the form of Sri Radha. This is Radha Tattva. So Radharani is a Shakti. Krishna, the Shaktiman. Supreme Feminine, Sri Radha, belonging to the Supreme Purusha, Krishna. From his own self. That is the position. Akrishnadas Kaviraj Goswami explains how this can happen. You can see in case of a deer, musk deer, murga, taraganda. Murga has a musk smell in himself, within himself. But the deer will keep searching for the smell and attracted by the smell. And the smell the deer has is from his own. So Supreme Lord Krishna is attracted to Sri Radha, which is from his own self. Or like fire and heat. You cannot separate fire and heat. Same way, you cannot separate Radha and Krishna. They're the same personality. In two different bodies, the aspect, pleasure aspect of Krishna. So Krishnadas Kaviraj talks this subject in Chaitanya Charitamrita, and he gives many names to Krishna, to Radharani, as an enchanter of Krishna. And he says, he's Govinda, Govinda Anandini. Govinda Anandini, who provides Ananda to Govinda. Govinda, he is the controller of all the senses. He is the one who gives pleasure to the senses. He is Govinda because he gives pleasure to cows and all the senses. And this person gets pleasure from Sri Radha. Govinda Anandini. Govinda Mohini. He attracts Govinda. Govinda Sarvasva. Everything. She is everything for Govinda. So all in all of Sri Krishna. And among all the different attractive things, different gopis, different Lakshmis, Krishna is Kanta. So everybody is enchanted. But among all the people who is enchanted, Sri Radha is Sarva Kanta Shiromani. She is the crest jewel of among all the people who are attracted to Krishna. So her attraction to Krishna is intense and supreme. So both ways. So this way Krishnadas Kaviraj explains. And Krishna says, he explains how Krishnadas Kaviraj explains how Krishna, his only purpose in Vrindavan is to look for Radharani. Any excuse. So he says, I'm going to graze the cows. I'm going to go with them. I'm going to different places and just to see where I can see you. That is his only purpose. So Supreme Lord enjoys his pleasure potency. And he does not do this for anybody else. He is doing it for himself. The Supreme Lord comes. People may understand, people may not understand. The Supreme Lord's position is as absolute enjoyer of everything. Bhoktaram, Ignatarasam. He is a person who enjoys all the emotions of all the living entities. And the supreme entity, Radharani. That is his position. So that is natural. So he does it only for his pleasure. He does not have to convince anybody. He does not have to be bothered about anybody, what people are going to think. This is natural. And the devotees have to understand this subject topic very, very carefully through the parampara process. So that we don't misunderstand. As Srila Prabhupada said, material attractions are like iron, and the attractions of Krishna and his gopis and his devotees are like gold. Both may be metal, but totally different levels. This is a position. It is very interesting to analyze the evolution of the concept of Sri Radha among the worshippers, among the devotees. Krishna was He appeared in Dwapara Yuga at the beginning of, until the beginning of Kali Yuga. He was present, the Prakada, pastimes of the Lord in this material world. When you had Vyasadeva compiling the Vedas, the Puranas, Bhagavatam, the supreme literature which will benefit people in Kali Yuga. But then you had in Kali Yuga people misusing the Vedas, doing totally opposite what the Vedas were saying, but through the Vedas, with Shastra Pramana. And we know Buddha came, and Buddha rejected the Vedas, totally brought in Bodhism, Abhinirvana, rejected the Vedas, Krishna himself in the form of Buddha Keshava Rupa, Buddha Sharira. And then reintroduction of the Shastra of Vedas by Adi Shankara, who we consider as Lord Shiva's incarnation to establish the Vedas through a covered form of monism, but the Shastras came back. Society cannot be without Vedas. Vedas brought in, which was done by Adi Shankara. Then you have the philosophy of dualism, Ramanuja, Madhva, Shuddha Dvaita. So these philosophies to bring in the concept of the Lord is different and the living needs are different. And the final aim of life is the connection, is the yoga, the connecting process of the living entities with the Supreme Lord through bhakti. So this is what the whole evolution is like. Of course, we had the Alwars of South India just after Krishna left, bringing out different emotions, bhakti rasa, Avdasya, Sakhiya, and even Vatsalya. When you had in Madhvas, you had the Dasapantas, who brought in those emotions. Of course, we had Jayadeva Goswami, Madhavendra Puri, who totally went and understood to full extent the connection between Krishna and Sri Radha. And it said that if anybody knows Krishna well, other than Radha, that is Madhavendra Puri in our line. So these people have brought in this concept of the final object of attraction, final fulfillment, the real pleasure living entities get in worshipping this jugala, this dual personalities, Radha and Krishna. So this has been the evolution. And of course, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu brought in, and all the Dasa Sahitya, all the Rasa Sahityas, Rasa Shastras of the Rasikas. Goswami's writings of the Goswami about this intense connection and as an object of meditation for the living entities and as their final aim in life to totally be absorbed in Radha and Krishna. So we see this evolution right from Krishna's time. Krishna left the Sas Vedas, rejection of Vedas, bringing in monism and the Vedas back, and understanding of dualism and the height of emotions of Krishna and his devotees, and in that the Radha Krishna connection. So this has been the evolution. So Radharani was originally not worshipped with Krishna. It was introduced by the Goswamis with the Shastric evidences. Of course, it was challenged by the then as Brahmanas, ritualistic Brahmanas. And of course, we know how Baladev with the abortion, he had to bring in, establish the worship of Radha and Krishna through the Shastras and write a commentary on the Vedanta Sutra. He called it Govinda Bhashya. Govinda himself revealed it to him. So Jayadeva Goswami onwards, we see these great personalities showing how Krishna and Radha, their connection. And Jayadeva Goswami went much further. He said how Krishna is attracted to Radharani. Now we know the story of how Jayadeva Goswami was writing about the relation between Radha and Krishna. And at one point he was confused because what came in his mind, what was revealed to him by Krishna, in his mind he was writing. And what was revealed just then was Krishna serving Radharani. The verse says, Krishna wanted to take Radharani's lotus feet and place it on his head. And he considered that is a great fortune for him. He stopped there. So we know how he got confused. He told his wife, I'm going to take bath. I'll come back and continue writing. And meanwhile, Lord Krishna comes in the form of Jayadeva to write that aspect. And he took the book, wrote it down. Of course, the scrolls, and he wrote it down. And when Jayadeva came back, wife said, you went, you came back. Again, you're coming now. And Jayadeva said, what happened? So Jayadeva asked for the writings and she presented to him. And he saw that what he wanted to complete was already completed by this Jayadeva, Krishna in the form of Jayadeva. and he understood Krishna's attraction for Radharani. So this was established from Jayadeva's time. And this is a subject matter of Gita Govinda by Jayadeva Goswami. And the Lord is very attracted to the Gita Govinda. We know the story of Jagannath ran away from the temple. He ran away from the altar. You know the story how some Devadasis were singing Gita Govinda of Jayadeva, and Jagannath in Puri, he got attracted. He opened the doors and he went away. Ran, it is said that he ran. He ran and thorns were poking him, and his dress got torn and his body got scratched, and he was just went to hear this Gita Govinda, the connection between Radha and Krishna. This subject matter enchants the Supreme Lord so much. And he ran. The next day, the pujaris came, all torn cloth, some kind of red marks. They were confused. The report went to the king. The king came, investigated what happened. Maybe some offenses happened. Somebody has broken in. But Jagannath had actually run out of the temple, even though it was locked. So the pujari was so confused. Of course, the Lord came in his dream and he said, no, I went out. I ran out. It's not your mistake. So the Supreme Lord is attracted to this connection. His attraction for Sri Radha, his attraction with the gopis. So we know all these things. Even Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he was attracted. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, we all know as the incarnation of Krishna, not just Krishna, but Sri Krishna in the form of Sri Radha, Radha Bhava. So he was always showing the different bhavas of Sri Radha in separation of Krishna. He was also attracted to Gita Govinda. It is said that how he ran out. Somebody was singing, some lady was singing Gita Govinda, and he ran. Of course, his servant Govinda had to catch him, say, no, this is not Gopi, this is just a Devadasi, probably it's a woman, and he stopped. So we see how this subject matter, the bhakti of Sri Radha to Krishna and the attraction of Sri Krishna on Radha and all Radharani's expansions, the primary gopis. So this was a subject matter established as the highest, the apex of religion, of dharma, the connection of jiva and Krishna, the attraction. What is the jiva to be attracted with? The jiva is supposed to get attracted to Radha and Krishna, how they are together. And Sri Radha is a worshipable object for the devotees. So the highest aspect of spiritualism is to gain mercy of this personality, Sri Radha. Why? Because Krishna is already attracted to her. And Krishna accepts anything that she says. Krishna accepts her position. Krishna accepts anybody who is projected by her. So everybody wants Sri Radha's mercy. And that is the height of bhakti, to get the mercy of Sri Radha. So Gaudiya Vaishnavas, getting her mercy, is the main aim of life. Once you get recognized by Sri Radha, then Krishna is achieved. Nobody looks for Krishna. Everybody looks for Sri Radha, to serve Sri Radharani. So by serving her, by getting her mercy, you get Krishna's mercy, because Krishna accepts anybody projected by Sri Radha. So devotees, the aim of life is to get this position. The position of being accepted by Srimati Radharani, being accepted by the expansions of Radharani, the different gopis, Dasa, Dasan, Dasa, being accepted by the devotee of the Supreme Lord. Now this is the height of Vaishnava spiritual status. So Sri Radha's position is that great, and devotees want that. In fact, she is called Sarvapalika, protector of the faith of Krishna. She protects the devotees' faith in Krishna. She sustains the bhakti of devotees. So if you want your bhakti to be sustained, right? So as a sadhaka, it's an up and down bhakti in Krishna, the spiritual life. If you want a very, very long-term, never deviated, never interrupted bhakti, then faith has to be strong. And that faith is what Radharani protects, Sarvapalita. She protects the interest of the devotees. Krishna in the minds of the devotees. She protects that. She protects the faith of the devotees. So if you want faith, she is the Lord. She is the Devata. She possesses that. And we have to get it from her. And how do we get it from her? Because faith is always connected to the heart. It's a feeling process, right? Thinking process is there, of course. That is the mental activity, feeling, thinking, feeling and willing. And thinking is a mental process. Willing brings out conviction and then action. But feeling, that is connected to the heart. And faith, the place for faith is heart. So unless we feel that faith in Krishna, we're going to increase our bhakti. And Radharani is in charge of the faith. She maintains the faith in Krishna. She releases it only to those people who are qualified to have faith in Krishna. Sarvapalika. She maintains this faith in Krishna, in all the devotees. That is her position. So one has to get her mercy to sustain our bhakti in Krishna. And that happens through activities. Because Radhika is expert in satisfying Krishna through her activities. That is why she is called Radhika. So there is no question of sitting in a corner and just thinking of Krishna. Bhakti means doing. Bhakti means acting, serving. She is the most expert in serving Krishna. And unless we have this expertise in getting the mercy of the devotees of Krishna, of Radharani, there is no question of getting an iota of faith in Krishna. So the service we do, bhakti that we do, whatever seva we do in our day-to-day life is a means to attract the attention of Srimati Radharani, to attract the attention of different devotees of Krishna. And that can happen only when we work and we serve with the devotees of Krishna. Hence the importance of Vaishnavas. Because all Vaishnavas are important to Radharani. Every sincere sadhaka, every sincere practitioner, he is the object of mercy of Srimati Radharani. So this association, working with Vaishnavas, in association, as Srila Prabhupada has given this place, just work with Vaishnavas, do service to Radha Krishna, because it is not you and Krishna, it is not you and Radharani. It is we and the different devotees. And by working, so serving them, satisfying them, we may be able to get the attention of the great gopis and Srimati Radharani. And automatically then Krishna's blessings, Krishna accepts. This is the importance of worshipping Radharani through Vaishnavas. This is the importance of associating with Vaishnavas, a life which is filled with sadhu sangha. What we do is not important, but where we do it, with whose sangha we do that, and on order. Because Radharani serves Krishna, and all the gopis serves Krishna. They want only see Radha and Krishna together, and they do exactly as Radharani wanted. And others who support these gopis do exactly as they wanted, and others. So this following, absolutely, is a prerequisite to increase the faith in Krishna due to the mercy of all the devotees, starting from Radharani onwards. This is one of the most important aspects of bhakti, association. So this is what happens in Vrindavan, Dhamma, Seva, when we stay in Dham, in Vrindavan. Everything is centered around Krishna. Everything is centered around helping Srimati Radharani in serving Krishna. Everybody is engaged in Vaishnava Seva. Everybody is thinking of to be servant of Srimati Radharani to get attraction, to get attracted to Krishna and to get Krishna's attention on us. This is Vrindavan mood. And for this, we need to understand the Seva Bhava of working together, Sadhu Sangha. Nobody is supreme. Radharani is the supreme in Vrindavan. She controls all the activities, all the sevas, all the bhakti activities to Krishna. If you want to please Krishna, then we have to follow the process of dasa, dasa, nudasa. That is only way. Because He has to be satisfied. And Krishna is attracted to Radharani. And the height of Radha Krishna interaction is Radha Dasya, the Supreme Lord serving His Supreme Devotee. In all religion, we know the Supreme Lord, we serve the Lord, we pray, we ask, we demand, we ask for protection, we worship Him, we satisfy Him. He is a served Lord, worshipped Lord. But here, the highest level of bhakti is that Krishna is a worshipper God. He is a served, he is not served, but he serves. He serves Srimati Radharani. And that is a connection. Krishna in separation of Srimati Radharani. This is the height of Vrindavan Ras. So Krishna is attracted because she enchants him. That is her position. So we get attracted to Radharani, we get attracted to Seva, we get attracted to Dasa, Dasa, Nudasa. Automatically you have the Supreme Lord. And Supreme Lord does not give himself up. He has already given himself up totally to Srimati Radharani. Only personality, he has given himself totally up. So much so that he serves her. When she is in separation, she goes and tries to satisfy her, please her. This vision is the highest form of meditation, followed by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and all the Rasika devotees. So this religion is complete. This spiritual process is complete, which provides a complete, opens up the complete ananda, possibilities of ananda a spirit soul can have. This is the mode of Vrindavan. Radha Dasya, Krishna attracted to Sri Radharani, trying to please her. This the Gaudiya Vaishnavas considers and establishes as the highest. So Radha and Krishna, the highest object of worship, and the highest in that, Sri Krishna serving Sri Radha completely. So Radharani always tries to attract the attention of Krishna, try to satisfy Krishna, gives pleasure to Krishna, Govinda Anandini. And she always try what opportunity is available. In fact, she got an opportunity to cook. She was a great cook. When she and the gopis were playing, young, and she would always have Krishna's deity form, whatever she does. Without the deity form of Krishna, she wouldn't do anything, it is said. So she would have the deity form of Krishna and play in front of that with the sakis. And one day it so happened on a Dwadashi day, seems Durvasa Muni came in where they were playing. Durvasa Muni came in and all the other gopis ran away, all the small girls ran away, seeing a sadhu, very fearful to look at, red dress, maybe a dadi. They all ran away. Radharani did not run. She stood there respectfully. So the Durvasa said, "So what are you doing? You're playing here." And what they were doing, they were actually playing cooking to serve Krishna. All imaginary parts, imaginary things and playing. So Durvasa said, "Okay, you cook for me today, sweet rice." So respectfully she ran, got all the ingredients. Rice, scented rice, milk, tejpat, spices, everything I made. And Durvasa Muni had that and he was in ecstasy. Never had this kind of food. She knew she is from spiritual world. That kind of a feeling. And Durvasa said, "I bless you. I bless you that whoever takes the food cooked by you would experience total spiritual ananda. This will satisfy them to the fullest extent. It will be extraordinary. Nobody in the whole creation can do the way you do it. That's my blessing." So she got that blessing. And everybody came to know about this. All the girls came back. They saw Durvasa came. She fed him. And he gave a boon. So everybody said, oh, Radharani got a boon. And what is the boon? That she will be expert cook, and whatever food she cooks will be beyond even nectar. So Yashoda also heard this. So she went to Radharani's place and they said, Radharani, let her come to my house and cook for my Krishna. So she got this opportunity in that name to always come to Krishna and cook for Krishna and serve him that way. So she's an expert cook. Nobody can do it better than her in satisfying Krishna through providing this nutritious, tasty, nectarian, spiritually charged food. This is Srimati Radharani's expertise. Another side, Krishna's expertise is in pleasing Srimati Radharani. Once Krishna spoke to Radharani, you are the greatest. Anybody chants your name will get me. Anybody approved by you will get me. I will not consider anybody as devotee unless they come through you. All this boasting, glorification of Radharani he was doing. Of course, Lalita is always there. Lalita will say, Radharani, don't hear to this person. He'll talk too much. Don't believe anything that he says. There's empty words. So Lalita, whose appearance day was a couple of days back, great Sakhi of Radharani, expansion of Radharani. Lalita and Vishakha. Vishakha appeared the same day as Radharani. The great Sakhis, who really understands the mood of Radharani in serving Krishna and assist Radharani in serving Krishna. They only want to see Radha and Krishna together. This is their job. So Krishna was boasting like this. Radharani said, is it? And Krishna said, not only that, you are more important to me than even my mother. Radharani said, how is that? She gave birth to you. She took care of you. Yashodamai. I can never be more than Yashoda. Krishna said, no, I'll prove it. Radharani said, okay. So one day it so happened. The gopis, they always want to see Radha and Krishna together. So they brought Radha and Krishna together and they were dancing. And the gopis assisting them in dancing, arranging everything. This is the evening after Krishna has gone for gracing and come back. Yashodamai comes in and she says all this dancing and playing going on and she gets angry. She says, what is this, Radha and all the Sakhis? My Gopal has just come back from gracing. He's tired. He has to take rest and you're disturbing him. And I heard this is happening every time. Radharani was quiet. But Sakhis said, no, Yashodamai, it's not the fact. This Krishna is different Krishna. This is not your Krishna, it's our Krishna. What do you mean, our Krishna? He looks like my son. He walks like that. He dances like that. He talks like that. He's my Krishna. But no. Your Krishna is at home, sleeping. Is it? Yogamaya covered her. And she kind of believed. Is it? Oh, there may be another Krishna. Now, your gopi said, you think there's only one Krishna? No. You go home and see, your Krishna must be sleeping. He is not good at all this dancing and loving and playing. He is just goes to grace and he comes. Our Krishna is great. He kills demons. He satisfies us. He is very lovable. He knows what is prema. Your Krishna does not know. Anyway, Yashodamai goes home and she sees Krishna lying down sleeping peacefully. So Krishna is lying there, so she thinks, my Krishna is here. Who is that Krishna? I felt the same attraction, the same bliss. And she gets an idea, because there's a Krishna there. There's a beautiful Krishna here. So she goes back and says, yes, my Krishna is there. Let us do one thing. This Krishna is so beautiful. My Krishna is so beautiful. So we have two Krishnas. Let us introduce them, each other. And we'll have two Krishnas. And they're so beautiful. And we can see both of them dancing. And they're dancing so beautiful to see. So Radharani was confused. Now what do we do? She looked at Krishna and she understood what Krishna's mind is. Only she can understand the mind of Krishna. Krishna does not have to talk to her. So she said, Yashodama, no. If you bring your Krishna, then how will I know which is my Krishna? You may take my Krishna away and I'll be left with your Krishna, which I don't want. So then the gopis, they consult, they decide, okay, they put a chandan dot on their Krishna. They said, okay, now you bring your Krishna. My Krishna has a sandalwood paste on his forehead. Your Krishna does not have. So let them dance, let them play, and let us enjoy. So both the Krishnas come, they dance. Yashoda is in bliss, all the gopis are in bliss. It was only one Neelamani which was dancing, blue sapphire. Now there are two blue sapphires dancing. So they're all in bliss. And dancing, 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 what happened? Both the Krishnas merged. Yashoda as Krishna merged into Radharani's Krishna. So there was only one Krishna. And Radharani and Yashoda was, okay, what happened to my Krishna? Where is he? Where did he hide? Radharani said, we are playing in the courtyard. There are four walls here. He cannot run away. This is my Krishna. I'm taking away. No, no, no. Don't take my Krishna away. So Radharani said, let us not quarrel. This is my Krishna, actually. You saw that. Maybe your Krishna has gone inside and sleeping. Radharani, Yashoda was crying. She said, I lose my life. I don't have 5, 6, 7 children. I only have one boy, one Gopal, and he's dear to me and Nanda Baba. We will die. And she kind of, you know, almost fainting and totally bewildered. So Radharani is getting so scared because Yashoda. So Radharani says, and then Yashoda tells Radharani, I will do whatever you want. I will be your maid servant. I will touch your lotus feet. Give the Krishna back to you. So Radharani said, no, no, don't touch my feet. I'm a young girl. I don't want to take any sin. Yashoda says, no, you won't get anything. Give back the Krishna, all sins will be gone. And she was almost fainting. And Krishna smiles and stands there. Radharani understood. Like she told, go home. Maybe he's sleeping. Your Krishna is sleeping. As soon as Yashoda heard that, life came back. She ran. She saw Krishna there. So Krishna proves this way that Radharani is more important than Yashoda. Yashoda had to actually beg Radharani for Krishna. Almost she had to touch Radharani's lotus feet. So Krishna gave this. So Krishna said, see, I told you, you are more important for me. So Krishna establishes through these leelas. And of course, when Radharani left the Rasa Leela, Krishna goes and pacifies her. So this is the highest form of worship. Sri Krishna serving Radharani and Radharani in separation of Krishna and the Vaishnavas and the devotees, great Sakis, want to please Radharani in her time. So this spiritual emotion, which has no tinge of material emotions, material contamination, this is pure. And to understand this is the goal of Gaudiya Vaishnavism, to transport from the material emotional level to the spiritual emotional level, where all attention is to Krishna and his angas, his devotees. That is the final in Krishna consciousness. So as Srila Prabhupada, our spiritual master, he has said, he has given this whole process, a hand-tailored, specially tailored process of sadhana bhakti for us all over the world, for devotees to follow. Just by following that, one could reach this highest bhava, highest form of attraction to Krishna and Sri Radha. Hare Krishna.